We are now updating our nodes and group colors whenever they have repeated names, so we are almost ready to start saving our data. However, we should first finish some extra features and fix some small problems we have to be able to do our saving as smooth as possible. We are going to start with one feature, which is whenever we select one or more nodes in a graph and create a new group with those nodes selected, then they should be added to that new group. This also means they should stop being ungrouped nodes and should become grouped nodes. Of course, we'll also have to do the opposite. Whenever we remove a group, every node inside of that group should leave it and become an ungrouped node, which currently doesn't happen. Let's start by adding the selected nodes to the created group. To do that, we'll of course need to go to our GraphViewCreateGroup method. In here, what we'll do is quite simple. We will iterate through the selection list the GraphView provides, which simply holds the currently selected elements in the graph, and if they are of type TS node, we will add them to the group through the addElement method. So type in for each graph element, selected element, in selection, and for our if check statement, we will continue to the next element if it is not of type TS node. So type in if not, and between parentheses type in selected element is TS node, and inside simply type in continue. Under our if statement, we can now create a variable of type TSNode, which I'll name node, and assign the cast selected element variable to it. Then we add it to our group by typing in group.addElement and pass in our node. If we save and go to Unity, we shall now be able to add our selected nodes into a newly created group. However, you might have noticed that if you create a new node, that the node added to the group still is an ungrouped node. That shouldn't be possible because we have our onGroupElementsAdded callback, which shall be called whenever an element is added to a group. And if you remember it right, in that method we remove a node from being an ungrouped node and make it be a grouped node. But if we go to our callback and type in a debug log with anything you might want, I'll type in callback called, and then save. Going back to Unity and adding a selected node to a newly created group, we can see that our debug.log isn't called. The reason why is pretty simple. When we are iterating through the selected nodes and adding them to our group is not yet part of the graph. That's because we only make our group part of the graph after we return from the method and call the addElement method in contextual menu and the search window. And because the group isn't part of the graph, it means our overrided callback won't be called, as our GraphView isn't listening for this group yet. So to fix this will be quite simple. We simply need to add our group to the GraphView before we add our nodes into it. This is as simple as calling in the addElement method before our forEach loop and passing our created group into it. With this, we'll of course not need to call in the addElement method whenever we call the createGroup method anymore, so feel free to remove those. You can of course remove the variable in the search window script as well. If we now save and go back to Unity, adding the selected nodes shall now call our debug.log message and become grouped nodes. Of course, don't forget to remove that debug.log line from the code as we don't really need it. With that done, all that's left is the removal of our group. We are able to do that already, but any node that's inside of the group will still be a grouped node. The reason why is that we are overriding the delete selection callback, so it no longer removes the nodes through the removeElement method automatically. And that means the onGroupElementsRemove callback will not be called for our nodes. What we'll do is again quite simple. We will iterate through the nodes in the group we are removing and remove them from the group using the removeElement method. This will call the GraphViewElementsRemovedFromGroup callback for each node. Of course, we shall not update the list we are iterating through, so we'll have to add them into a list and remove them using that list. Thankfully, because you don't really need anything else, we won't need to iterate through that list and we'll simply be able to use the removeElements method, which is the same as the removeElement method but accepts a list. So in our groups to delete for each, we'll create a new list of type tsNode, to which I'll name group nodes and initialize it. Then we will iterate through the group contained elements variable, which shows all elements inside of this group. So type in for each graph element group element in group.containedElements, and inside, if it is not of type tsNode, we will simply continue to the next element. So if not group element is tsNode, then we continue. Otherwise, we'll add it to the list by creating a variable of type tsNode, which I'll name group node, and assign the group element variable into it and casting it. Then add this node to the group nodes list. We now have our list of nodes that we want to remove from the group. So type in after our loop group.removeElements and pass in our group nodes list. With this, the callback shall now be called. Just to keep things more consistent, I'll place the removeGroup method call we have in our first for each in our groups to delete for each before our removeElement line. Remember that you don't really need to create these variables and instead just pass in the casted element to the add method instead, if you prefer that. But in my case, I will leave it as is because I like it better. If we now save and go to Unity, both adding and removing should work without a problem.